Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Bully. Today I am going to show you guys how to build a print-on-demand store using the Invition Print and Ship plugin in WordPress. Invition Print and Ship is another third-party print-on-demand provider. There are so many print-on-demand plugins out there that you guys could use to build a print-on-demand store. You guys need to explore and try many of them to find which one would be the best or which one would meet your business needs. But before we get started, I want to welcome back all my subscribers. I appreciate you all. But for those who are brand new to my channel, my name is Bully. I create tutorials about e-commerce web designs, focusing on user experience using WordPress. All right, with that being said, let's jump right in. All right, let's go to our demo store, go to plugins, scroll up a little bit and click the add new button on the top. Go to the search box on the right and type Invision Print and Ship. We are going to install the one that is on the left. Click the install button. Once you are done installing it, don't forget to click the activate button to activate the plugin. And you should be redirected back to the main plugins page. Scroll down a little bit to find the plugin so we can enable the auto update feature right there, and scroll to the right to click the link to enable the auto update. Click the settings right there to go to the main settings. Usually there are a couple of menus that are under this plugin. You could see all these menus on the left. First, before we can configure this plugin, we're gonna need to apply for a user API key. Let's go to invision.eu, click the start selling button on the top, and we need to pick that option for automatic ordering. Click the register for automated ordering button. Fill out the form on this page. Once you click the register button at the bottom, you will get a notification message at the bottom saying that they will reply back to your email address that you provided within in 1 day. So your API key should be ready by then. All right, it's 1 day later here. Hooray, I got my API credentials in my email now. Before you could use the print and ship plugin, make sure you install the WooCommerce plugin first. It's very important. I already have this plugin installed on my demo store. So you should be able to see your WooCommerce menu on the left. All right, let's go to Invision menu, go to settings. All right, the first tab is for general. Copy the API user code in your email and paste it here. Do the same for the API key box below it. Leave the rest of the settings the same, except the accept back orders option at the bottom. And then just select from the drop-down box to pick do not allow. Once everything looks good, just click the save button at the bottom. Next, scroll up to the top for a little bit to click the product updates tab. As for these settings in this tab, just leave them as they are because the default settings are quite good already. Then scroll down to click the save button at the bottom once everything looks good. Next, scroll up to the top a little bit to click the email tab. As for the settings in this tab, we use this for the header and the footer for the WooCommerce tracking email. Enter your email subject in the top box. You should see how the subject will look like in the example box on the right side. Also, don't forget to enter the email title next to. Then enter the text for the tracking in the last box at the bottom. Once your tracking email template looks good, click the save button at the bottom. Next, scroll up to the top a little bit to click the Gift Items tab. Click the Save button at the bottom. We use these settings to automatically add gift items, custom packaging, or other free items. Don't worry about these tabs, so just click the next tab. That is shipping. Just leave the settings in this tab alone for the Invision Print and Ship plugin to calculate your shipping automatically by default. Then just click the Save button at the bottom once everything looks good. Next, click Create a product on the menu to your left. We're gonna add a product after we check out other items first. Let's click the product updates on to your left. This is for updating product data from Invision. Right now, we don't have any products yet, but as recommended, you need to run the update feature weekly. Just select a product to update on this page. Next, the support menu. If you need help, just write an email to the support team. Their email address is right up there. As for the tools menu, don't worry about this feature because you will use this feature when you made a lot of changes to your products. I'm not gonna cover about this feature in this tutorial. All right, let's go back to the Create a Product menu. There are two types of products, which are a single product and variable product. First, we're gonna create a single product. Click the Create a Simple Product button. You could search for a product in the search box on the top right, or you could navigate to different pages by clicking the angle symbols. There are about over 400 items that they sell. Let's go to the second page. I'm gonna pick an iPhone 11 hard case. Scroll up to the top to select Add as New Product in the drop-down box and click Apply. The product was created successfully. Let's go to the products page. Click the products item under the WooCommerce menu on the left panel. Click the title of your product to edit the product. Edit the title to make it search engine optimization. Add the product description to that box on the top. This description will be displayed at the bottom of your products page. Select a product category or create a new one right here by clicking the Add New Category if you need to create a new one. And then don't forget to add a product tag underneath that category, so people could search for your products easily within your online store. After you are done with that, scroll down a little bit. You could see the Invision Print and Ship section right there. Click the button Add Image right there to upload an image to your phone case. But before we continue to the next step, if you find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up so other people can find my content too. Thank you for your support. Next, we're gonna add a product image on the right. Click Set Product Image. I don't have a good product image to show here. I'm gonna use this one for now. Apparently, if you're gonna use the Invision Print and Ship plugin, you need to have your own phone case images to add to your store manually. Let's scroll down to the product data section next. Add a regular price in the first box here in the general tab. Then add a sale price in the next box so you could attract more customers if your product is on sale or the original price is crossed out. Scroll down a little bit more to add a product short description here in the box below. This description will be shown at the top of the product page. Once everything looks good, just scroll up a little bit more to click the Publish button on the right side. Let's go to the front end to take a look at this product. Refresh the store. go to the shop menu or wherever your product is. There it is! Click on the product image to see more details. Scroll down a little bit to see more information that we just entered. It looks like the price is all correct. So far, it looks all right. All the model information is right here. All right, next, let's go back to the Invision menu to create a new product. This time, we're gonna create a variable product. Click the Create a Variable Product button. Enter the name of your product in the box. Select the models. Let's select Apple iPad 2, 3, and 4, and then select the case types and colors. Let's select Soft Case Transparent. Don't forget to select the brand. Once everything looks good, just click the next button at the bottom. Click Choose File to upload a print image for the iPad. And then click the Finish Product button. Once the product is successfully created, go to the Products page. Click the Enter Product Details button. Add the product description that will be displayed at the bottom of the product page. Add a product category or select an existing one right here. Also add some product tags for the search engine and click the Add button whenever you're done to add a product tag. And then scroll down a little bit to click on the product image to select or upload an image to display in your online store. Invision Print and Ship doesn't provide you with a mockup image, so you have to come up with your own in this case. Once you are done, just scroll down a little bit to the product data section. Click on the Attributes tab first. Click each tab to expand to check on the attributes if they are correct. Uncheck the visible on the product page option so it won't show on the product page for all the tabs. You don't need that information on the page. Add a short description in the box below that will go on top of the page. Once everything looks good, just scroll up a little bit to click the Publish button. And then let's go to the front end to refresh the store to check out this product. Click the product image. Uh-oh, it looks like this product is currently out of stock and unavailable. All right, let's go back to the back end to create a new variable product again. Click Create a Product under the Invision menu to your left. Click Create a Variable Product and select a brand in the first box from the left. Select the models. Let's select Apple iPad Mini 3 and 4. Then select Soft Case Transparent. Click the next button and then click Choose File right here in this page to upload a print image. Next, then click Finish the Product. The product was successfully created. Go to the products page by clicking products on the left under the WooCommerce. Click the product name to edit the product details. Edit the title and the slug tag for the URL. And then enter the long product description in the top box. Pick an existing product category or create a new one. Add a product tag and press enter or click the add button when done. You can add a couple of product tags for a better SEO here. Scroll down a little bit to enter a product short description. This information will be displayed at the top of the product page. Then scroll up a little bit to check on attributes, uncheck the use for variations option in the case type and color and brand tabs. We don't need this information to show on the product page. We already specified the details in the product title. Once everything looks good, just click the Save Attributes button. A little pause here. If you guys want to support my channel, I add all the links in the description box below for you guys to check out. Thank you so much for your support to help me continue to provide a free web design tutorial like this. Let's get back to the tutorial. Next, click Variations. Select Create Variations from All Attributes. From the drop-down box, click Go, click OK on the pop-up box. Make sure to check on the attributes to make sure they are correct, because sometimes they may not. You can add or remove anything unrelated here. Click to expand each tab to add a regular price and a sale price. Once it looks good, scroll down a little bit to click the Save Changes button within this section. Next, don't forget to add and set a product image. You need to come up with your own product images because the plugin doesn't give you product mockups at all. Once everything looks good, scroll up a little bit to click the Publish button. Let's go to the front end to check it out. Refresh the page and click the product image. It looks like it displays the brand and the case type information. The information is redundant. We don't want them to be here. So let's go back to the back end again real quick to check if we uncheck the used for variations option in the attributes tab. Make sure to uncheck it in the brand and case type tab. Click the save attributes button once done. And then let's go back to the front end again to refresh the demo store to see the changes we just made. All right, it's gone now. It is working. We can see there are three models for the customers to choose from. The information in the additional information tab is correct too. Let me know in the comments below if you guys want to use this plugin to sell phone cases. Let's scroll up a little bit to add this item to the shopping cart to check out. Let's click on the shopping basket icon on the top right to see the items. I need to remove the desk from the last tutorial here. The shopping cart is updated now and click the proceed button to check out as a customer. That's pretty much it for today's tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe for more e-commerce web designs using WordPress tutorials to help you make money online and turn on that notification bell. Have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you in my next video. Bye now.